Today I will start my discussion with the topic reflection coefficient. So this reflection coefficient is related to the transmission line equations. This reflection coefficient will give you the analysis of solutions of transmission line equations. While in transmission line, traveling wave along the line contains two components, one traveling in positive z direction and other traveling in negative z direction. So reflection coefficient is related to the solutions of problems in transmission line, while in the traveling wave along the transmission line consisting of two components, one is traveling in the positive z direction and other is traveling in the negative z direction. If the load impedance is equal to the line characteristic impedance, the reflected traveling wave does not exist. Why your reflected traveling wave you are having in a transmission line when impedance of total impedance of the or load impedance is equal to the line characteristic impedance, both are not equal when both are load impedance and line characteristic impedance, when both are equal, reflected traveling wave does not exist. When these impedances, load impedance and line characteristic impedance, are not equal, so reflected traveling wave will be existent. So that load impedance, how it is connected in the first figure of transmission line, we have seen that circuit diagram of the transmission line you are going to get. So now this usually a more convenient to start the solving the transmission line problem, we will start from the receiving end, not from the sending end, because voltage to current relationship at the load point is fixed by the load impedance. Usually we have to start to solve the problems of the transmission line, we have to consider from the receiving end instead of sending or transmitting end, because voltage to current relationship at the receiving end will be terminated or fixed by the load impedance. So therefore the incident voltage and current waves traveling the transmission lines are given by the transmission coefficient. The incident voltage and current waves traveling along the transmission line are given by the reflection coefficient. This reflection coefficient is designated or represented by gamma. Okay, it is defined as, reflection coefficient is defined as, it is the ratio of reflected voltage to incident voltage, or it may be defined as reflected current to incident current. So therefore gamma is equal to V reflected divided by V incident, or gamma is equal to I reflected divided by I incident. So this is about your reflection coefficient of transmission line. Now I will move on to another topic which is related to the transmission line, transmission coefficient. So usually a transmission line terminates its characteristic impedance Z0 is called properly terminated line. A transmission line terminated by its characteristic impedance, that is called as a properly terminated transmission line. If your transmission line is not terminated with the characteristic impedance Z0, then that line, transmission line, is called as the improperly terminated line. So therefore we have described, we know that in previous classes there is a reflection coefficient gamma at any point along the improperly terminated line. Reflection coefficient gamma will be on the point along the improperly terminated line. Improperly terminated line means your transmission line will not be terminated by its characteristic impedance. So therefore, principle of conservation of energy, the incident power minus the reflected power must be equal to the power transmitted to the load. What is the condition of the principle of conservation of energy in the transmission line? The incident power minus reflected power must be equal to the power transmitted to the load. So this can be expressed as T is equal to, that is transmission coefficient T is equal to, it is the ratio of transmitted voltage to the incident voltage or transmitted current to the incident current. So therefore, transmission coefficient is equal to V transmitted divided by V incident, or transmission coefficient T is equal to, in terms of current ratio, I reflected, Y transmitted to the I incident. So therefore, now I will move on to the standing wave and standing wave ratio. The general solutions of the transmission line equation consist of two waves traveling in opposite direction with unequal amplitude. What is standing wave and standing wave ratio? The general solutions of the transmission line equation consisting of two waves traveling in opposite direction with unequal amplitude. Those equations are shown in the following figure. V is equal to V plus e to the power of minus alpha z into e to the power of minus j beta z plus V minus e to the power of alpha z into e to the power of j beta z. So these are the two, this is, one is positive component, one is negative component. So therefore, but these are in unequal amplitude. So that is equal to, if you take from this common V plus e to the power of minus alpha z, the common is cos beta z minus j sin beta z, plus in the second term V minus e to the power of minus alpha z. So that will be replaced by cos beta z plus j sin beta z. So in both the two things, cos beta z you can take outside common. So you will be remaining with V plus e to the power of minus alpha z plus V minus e to the power of alpha z into cos beta z minus, I am taking here at the second term sin beta z common, but remaining with j into V plus e to the power of minus alpha z minus V minus e to the power of alpha z into sin beta z. So with this no loss in general case, it can be assumed that V plus e to the power of minus alpha z and V minus e to the power of alpha z are real parts. These are all real parts. Then the voltage wave equation can be expressed as voltage wave equation is equal to V naught into e to the power of j minus j phi. V voltage is equal to, this is voltage wave equation, is equal to V naught into e to the power of minus j pi. So this is called as equation of the voltage standing wave. This is called as V is equal to V naught into e to the power of minus j pi. That is called as voltage standing wave. Here V naught is equal to V plus e to the power of minus alpha z plus V minus e to the power of alpha z whole square cos square beta z plus V plus e to the power of minus alpha z minus V into e to the power of alpha z whole square sin square beta z under the root. So therefore, this phi is equal to arc tan of p plus e to the power of minus alpha z minus v minus e to the power of alpha z divided by v plus e to the power of minus alpha z plus v minus e to the power of alpha z into tan beta z. This equation is called as phase pattern of the standing wave. So this equation is called as equation of the voltage standing wave ratio, voltage standing wave, whereas in this wave this phi is called as this given by arc tan of this term in bracket. So this is called as phi is called as phase pattern of the standing wave, phase pattern of the standing wave. So now I will move on to the next. By doing so, you have to substitute proper values of frequency in the equation. First one, we are going to find the maximum amplitude of the standing wave, V max. The maximum amplitude of the standing wave, V max is equal to V plus e to the power of minus alpha z plus V minus e to the power of alpha z is equal to V plus e to the power of minus alpha z into 1 plus magnitude of gamma, and this will be occur at beta z is equal to n pi, where n is equal to 0 plus or minus 1 and plus or minus 2, etc. Second thing, after substitution of frequency in above equation in z direction, the minimum amplitude of standing wave is, voltage standing wave is, V minimum is equal to V plus e to the power of minus alpha z minus V minus e to the power of alpha z is equal to V plus e to the power of alpha z into 1 minus magnitude of gamma. This occurs at beta z is equal to 2n minus into pi by 2, where n is equal to 0 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2, etc. So this is the figure where your standing wave looks like this. So in the standing waves, you are having current voltage, a current signal may be there, or say a current wave may be there, or voltage wave may be there. In this here, your dark line is called as used to represent the voltage standing wave, and dashed line is called as the is used to represent the current standing wave, right? No, so the distance between this two peak, distance between two peak of this amplitude is called as lambda by 2. This is lambda by 2 for voltage wave. This is lambda by 2 for current wave. This is the amplitude of, this is the V max, what I told, the maximum amplitude of standing wave V max is given by this equation. This is the maximum value of voltage of voltage standing wave ratio, minimum value of the voltage standing wave ratio. Okay, now I will move on to the what is standing wave ratio. So these standing waves are resulted from the simultaneous presence of traveling waves in opposite direction in transmission line. Okay, the standing waves are resulted from the simultaneous presence of traveling waves in opposite directions on transmission line. So the ratio of the maximum value of the standing wave pattern to the minimum value of the standing wave pattern is defined as standing wave ratio. What is standing wave ratio? That means directly I am going to say in the previous figure, standing wave ratio is nothing but it is the ratio of maximum voltage to minimum voltage. So if you want to define this, the standing wave existed or results from the simultaneous presence of the traveling waves in transmission line, which is in opposite direction, that is called as a, that will be create the standing waves. The ratio of the maximum standing wave pattern to the minimum standing wave pattern is defined as the standing wave ratio. So this standing wave ratio can be represented by rho is equal to, again same, it will be standing wave ratio will be again represented in terms of voltage or current. So rho is equal to magnitude of b max to the magnitude of v minimum, or rho is equal to standing wave ratio, rho is equal to magnitude of current, maximum current standing waves to the minimum current, magnitude of the minimum current standing waves. This is how you are going to consider the discussion of standing waves and standing wave ratios. Now I will move on to the important topic in this module, is Smith chart with respect to what is transmission line. So to solve the problems or computations required to solve the transmission line problems, the solution of such problems in the tedious and difficult in the transmission line, to get the accurate manipulation of numerous equations is necessary. Smith chart means, Smith chart is used to compute the or to solve the transmission line problems. This solutions of transmission line problems consist of rather than complicated equations. The solutions of such problems is tedious and difficult because accurate manipulations of the numerous equations is unnecessary. It is necessary. What is accurate manipulation of numerous equations is necessary. So therefore, to simplify that solution, we need a graphical method of arriving a quick solution for the problems which we are having in the transmission line. To simplify the solutions in transmission line, we need a graphical method to get a quick answer or quick solution. The number of impedance charts we have designed, the number of impedance charts are designed to facilitate the graphical solution of the transmission line problems. So far, basically, all the charts are derived from the fundamental relationship expressed in the transmission line equations. Basically, all the charts derived for the solution, finding the solutions of transmission line, they are the fundamental relationship expressed in transmission line equations. The most popular chart which is used to solve the complicated problems in transmission line, that is developed by a Philip H. Smith, this development of or the investigation of this Smith chart, it is having a purpose of this section to represent the graphic solution to the problems in the transmission line by using Smith chart. What is the main purpose of Smith chart is, purpose of the Smith chart is to present the graphic solutions of transmission line problems by using Smith chart. This Smith chart consists of, it is a plot, graphical representation means it is a plot of the normalized impedance. Smith chart is a plot of the normalized impedance or admittance with the angle and magnitude of a generalized complex reflection coefficient in a unity circle. Smith chart consists of a plot of the normalized impedance or admittance with angle and magnitude of generalized complex reflection coefficient in a unity circle. The chart is applicable to analysis of a lossless line as well as a lossy line. This Smith chart is used to find the solution for lossless line and lossy line. Lossless line means what? A total transmitted power from the source will be completely delivered to the load, when it is called as lossless transmission, because characteristic impedance must be equal to the load impedance. Z naught is equal to load. Then only complex total power transmitted from the source to the load will be delivered. Otherwise, if these two impedance, load impedance and characteristic impedance of the transmission line is not equal, then that line is having the some problem or standing waves are created because total power is not delivered to the load. There must be a loss in the transmission line. So therefore, that line is called as a lossy line. So this Smith chart is used to find the solutions for lossless line and lossy line. By simple rotation of the chart to find the solution, just you are having the unity circle is there and it is having the graphical representation of the impedance and admittance will be there. Just you are rotating the chart, the effect of the position on the line can be determined. The effect of the transmission line can be determined by using the Smith chart. Okay, now this is how you are going to, this is the constant R circle or constant resistance circle. This is a reflection coefficient gamma, both in x-axis and z-axis. See here, these are having unity circles. This is unity radius having r is equal to 1. This is r is equal to 2. And this is r is equal to 0.5 radius. This is r is equal to 0.4 radius. So these circles are already printed in the resistance circle. These circles in this Smith chart is called as radiation or resistance circles. Similarly, you are having another circle or same. All these curves are printed in the Smith chart like this. This type of graphical representation is called a reactance circle. Circles are used. Previous circles represented in the Smith charts are called as a resistance circles. And this is called as a reactant circles. X circles are reactant circles which are having the radius like this. Okay, so this part is called as 1 over x. This above this reflection coefficient gamma part is called as 1 over x. So this here above this line, reference line or reflection coefficient line, so in the clockwise direction from 0 point, it is used to represent the positive real imaginary parts, jx component 0.5, 1.0, so it is divided like this. And in the anti-clockwise direction, negative imaginary parts are used to represent. Minus jx are used in the anti-clockwise direction. This will represent the 0.2 radius circle, 0.1 radius circle, 0.2 radius circle. So like this, you are having various circles here. Whatever the minus real part is there, you can represent, choose your value. And positive real parts are there, you can choose your values like this. Okay, so this is how you are having the different representation of circles with different radius and imaginary parts, positive imaginary part and negative imaginary parts. And I will stop here today's discussion, and in next class I will take up what are the characteristics of this Smith chart, and we'll see in next class. Thank you. I will stop this session.